Rajasthan government has announced a farm loan waiver in its state budget. This will cover loans of up to 50,000 rupees for small and marginal farmers and will cost the exchequer about 8,000 crore rupees. Not only that, the Chief Minister, Vasundhara Raje, who also holds the finance portfolio, has announced an allocation of 350 crore rupees for building new warehouses. The farming sector side, the Raje government has announced that around 77,000 new posts will be created in the education sector. The government will also distribute sanitary pads for free in state-run schools. Well, joining us now is the Agriculture Minister of Rajasthan, Mr. Prabhu Lal Saini. Mr. Saini, appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV 18. Let me start by asking you about your government's decision to announce a farm loan waiver of 50,000 rupees for small and marginal farmers, sir. We understand that the cost to the exchequer is about 8,000 crore rupees. How many impacted farmers will this scheme help? You've set up a farm relief commission and you say that farmers will get relief basis merit. Can you explain the mechanics of this scheme to us?
देखिए अभी राजस्थान में जो आज बजट घोषणा हुई इस बजट घोषणा में माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी ने आजादी के बाद पहली बार राजस्थान में किसी भी सरकार हो चाहे 52 साल तक कांग्रेस ने राजस्थान में राज किया है लेकिन कभी भी किसान के कर्जे माफ करने के बारे में कोई विचार नहीं हुआ और आप ये देखेंगे कि लगभग 20 से 25 लाख किसानों को इसका फायदा मिलेगा स्मॉल फार्मर मार्जिनल फार्मर एसटी और एससी के जो छोटे किसान हैं, वो अपना लोन जो समय पे नहीं जमा करा पा रहे थे उनके इंटरेस्ट बढ़ा हुआ था तो ऐसे ओवरड्यू वाले जो भी है जो लगभग 30 सितंबर 2017 तक जितने भी किसानों के ओवरड्यू थे उनको 50,000 रुपए तक के कर्जे माफ करने की घोषणा आज बजट में की
लेकिन सर जो डिमांड ऑपोजिशन की थी और जो फार्मर्स की डिमांड है जब वो प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे थे सीकर में भी तो उन्होंने कहा था कि फुल फार्म लोन वेवर होना चाहिए आपने पार्शियल फार्म लोन वेवर आज अनाउंस किया है बजट में तो ऑपोजिशन तो इस बात को लेकर सरकार के मत में नहीं बोल रही है
देखिए ऑपोजिशन से सरकारें नहीं चलती है
नहीं नहीं ऑपोजिशन से ना भी चले सर फार्मर्स की डिमांड भी थी कि फुल फार्म लोन वेवर होना चाहिए
देखिए डिमांड तो कोई भी कुछ कर सकता है लेकिन वित्तीय प्रावधान और वित्तीय स्थिति को देखते हुए पहली बार हम लोगों ने कर्जा माफी का एक बहुत बड़ा फैसला मुख्यमंत्री जी ने लिया है मैं समझता हूँ कि जब इनकी विपक्ष की सरकार भी थी 5 साल पहले तो इनको किसने रोका था माफ करने के लिए कर्जा माफ करने के लिए किसानों के कल्याण के लिए किसने रोका इनको लेकिन इन्होंने इनका कोई विजन नहीं था इन्होंने नहीं चाहा किसान का भला और अब इस तरह की जो घड़ियाली आंसू बहाने वाले जी ये बात लोग कर रहे हैं
जी
मैं समझता हूँ अनफॉर्चुनेट बिकॉज अभी पहले स्टेप पे जो हुआ दूसरा एक फार्मर्स के ऋण माफी के बारे में एक कमीशन बनाने की जो बात की
जी
इसी प्रकार आप देखेंगे केरल में जो कांग्रेस की सरकार है उन्होंने भी इसी प्रकार कमीशन बनाकर उसमें हियरिंग का काम होता है
तो
मैं समझता हूँ
तो आप कह रहे हैं कि ये एक फर्स्ट स्टेप है और पार्शियल लोन वेवर है क्योंकि आपको फिस्कल डेफिसिट और फिस्कल पोजीशन का भी ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा और वो जायज और लिजिटिमेट कंसर्न है लेकिन मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहूंगी कि आगे का क्या सोचा है आपने लोन वेवर तो एक बात है सर लेकिन जैसे प्राइस डिफिशियंसी मैकेनिज्म है कि ये तो प्रोडक्शन जो थी वो ज्यादा थी लेकिन MSP से भी कम दामों का दाम मिल रहे थे फार्मर्स को तो आगे चलकर के ये स्थिति ना वापस से पैदा हो उसके आप ऊपर क्या काम कर रहे हैं
मैडम मैं आपके माध्यम से सारे देश को ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि राजस्थान में हम लोगों ने जहाँ भी डिजास्टर हुआ राजस्थान में 4 वर्षों में हम लोगों ने 7,100 करोड़ से ज्यादा का पैसा उन किसानों के खाते में ट्रांसफर किया जिनकी फसलें नष्ट हो गई और लगभग 3600 करोड़ रुपए 3,600 करोड़ के रुपए के लगभग हम लोगों ने फसल बीमा योजना के अंतर्गत भी ऐसे किसानों को जो कि बैंक के लोन ही थे कोऑपरेटिव से लोन लिए थे उन लोगों को भी हम लोगों ने लगभग 3600 करोड़ रुपए इसके आधार पे भी उनको राहत पहुंचाने का काम हमने किया है हमारा ये प्रयास होगा कि निश्चित रूप से फार्मर्स की इनकम डबलिंग टू अप टू 2022 इसके बारे में हमारा ये विजन है कि अभी आपने देखा होगा कि पूरे राजस्थान में अभी जो जिस प्रकार किसानों के द्वारा ये जो दिया जाता था आपके राजस्व वसूली जो होती थी आपके इरिगेशन लैंड का जो लगान होती थी
जी
पहली बार लगान फ्री कर दिया हम लोगों ने किसी प्रकार का इरिगेटेड लैंड का किसी भी प्रकार का पैसा किसान को नहीं लेंगे हमने उसको फ्री किया है इसके साथ में हम लोगों ने और भी कोशिश की है कि प्रोसेसिंग वैल्यू एडिशन को बढ़ावा देने के काम भी हम लोग करेंगे हमारे
जी प्रभुलाल जी, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आज हमसे बात करने के लिए. द एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर देयर ऑफ राजस्थान प्रभुलाल सैनी. लेट्स ब्रिंग इन अ वॉइस फ्रॉम द ऑपोजिशन नाउ. सचिन पायलट, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द राजस्थान कांग्रेस, जॉइंस अस. सचिन, अप्रिशिएट यू जॉइनिंग अस हियर. यू जस्ट हर्ड द एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर देयर सेइंग दैट लुक, इट्स फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट अ गवर्नमेंट इन राजस्थान हैज अनाउंस्ड अ लोन वेवर ऑफ 50,000 रुपीज फॉर स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स, एंड ऑफ कोर्स लिस्टिंग आउट अ होल बंच ऑफ अदर इनिशिएटिव्स दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग टू टेक फॉरवर्ड. डू यू बिलीव दैट दिस विल अलीविएट द पेन that's been felt in Rajasthan on account of the agri distress?
The agrarian crisis is rampant, not just in Rajasthan, but in over entire of North India, especially. You see, this budget today that the Chief Minister read out, you must look at the background in which this is happening. A, this so-called partial farm loan waiver is not what it is. It is only for farmers who have taken loans from the cooperative banks, not from nationalized banks. 90% of the farmers take loans from banks, not cooperative banks. Now, I heard the minister talk about insurance. The sad tragedy of this state is that amount of money that the farmers have paid in as premiums is far larger than any payout that the government of Rajasthan has made. 10 lakh farmers even today are waiting for the crop failure damage that they were supposed to get compensated for 2 years ago. And this announcement that Chief Minister made, the total burden is about 7,000 to 8,000 crores. But look at the trap in which the BJP is falling, Shireen. In Uttar Pradesh, Mr. Yogi, a BJP CM, announces 35,000 crores for loan waiver. Maharashtra CM reluctantly, but then announces almost a 40,000 crore loan waiver. So the people are asking, if other CMs of BJP are doing it, why shouldn't Rajasthan do it? And today she knows in 7 months' time, there'll be a new government. They're about to go. 7 months is what the life of this assembly is. And they know they're going to get voted out. So this announcement today, really, I think is just on paper. There'll be no execution on the ground. And even now, look at the amount, 50,000 rupees per farmer. You don't even get a good buffalo 50,000 rupees. The average loan amount is between 4 to 5 lakh rupees. So if you really had the interest of the farmers in mind, A, you would have done this 4 years ago. But and B, you would have implemented this farm loan so-called waiver with other measures of MSP, bonus, price mechanism, like you said, other aspects, so that the ecosystem improves and the farmers can stand on their feet again.
Okay, just on the second part of the argument that you made there, Sachin, on why is this only 8,000 crore rupees and why is it not 35 or 40,000 crore rupees like we've seen being announced by other BJP governments. And the minister's argument there was that, look, we have to keep the fiscal situation in mind. I'm looking at the numbers now. Estimated fiscal deficit of 2.98%, revenue deficit of over 17,500 crores almost, that's including the Uday scheme. So they don't really have the fiscal elbow room, Sachin, to have done any better than this.
You see, the political compulsions of the BJP is such that the government of India has said, we want nothing to do with it. Other chief ministers are now doing it, so the competitiveness has seeped in, first of all. Second of all, Shireen, 5 years ago when Vasundhara Raje took over, 4 years ago, the public debt was 1,20,000 crores. Today, it's 2,40,000 crores. So you're taking loans to help out certain individuals, but the farming community that needs help the most, you're not helping them. 36,000 bighas of land has been given to people to develop so-called solar plants. Not a single plant has even started. So there is a lot of crony capitalism at the top echelons of the Rajasthan government, but the farming community has been used as a bait, because they really had the interest of the farmers in mind. Today, hang on, the minister said, humne lagan maaf kar diya. You know, lagan is only put on irrigated land. How much of land is irrigated in Rajasthan? Less than 30%. And that also, it's a nominal charge. So these are, yes, irrigated land. So most of the land is rain-fed. So already there is drought, there is hailstorm, there is flood. So you keep waving lagans every year. It's really of no consequence. What really CF should have done, CM, was to ensure that the farmers' produce will be procured by the state agencies. They are in hand in glove with the the mafia that controls the food grains. So if they ensure that the MSP will be executed and the crop will be lifted, that's all the farmers want. Farmer wants adequate compensation for what he produces. They don't want these freebies, they don't want subsidies, they want money for their produce. And that these hoarders and these black marketeers don't allow the government to do, because they're in cahoots with them.
Okay, so you're saying that this is too little, too late. But Sachin, I want to go back again to the point that the minister was making. And when I asked him the question on what will be the impact of this on the ground, and the number that he gave me is that it will impact at least 20 to 25 lakh farmers. You're saying that that is not accurate?
Because the actual numbers, we don't know how many people will be in that bracket to be using that farm loan waiver. They formed a committee to look into the farm loan waiver scheme. The committee said, yes, we shouldn't do it, we can't do it. But, you know, the recent by-election results are there for all of us to see. And I think this budget has the by-election laws written right all over it. So in 7 months' time, how much of those irrigation projects can be executed? How much of the farm loan waiver can be actually implemented? You know, in 6 months' time, you'll have the notification for the elections. So this really is a budget made last minute and just to please, you know, on paper. And these are all schemes that are not going to be able to be implemented. Sadly, she missed a golden opportunity. 5 years of a massive majority, she could have turned the agrarian sector around. She all allowed 80 farmers to commit suicide, and the fag end to give some lollipops on paper is not going to help them at all.
Okay, so since you're talking about this being a by-election loss budget, Sachin, and you're absolutely confident and certain that it's going to be the Congress that comes to power once the elections are held, which is 7 months down the line, what is your prognosis and your prescription to address the agrarian economy?
You see, first of all, I'm confident, but I'm not complacent. And I don't have the sense of arrogance about winning elections and being in power forever. We worked hard, and I believe people will support us. That's why I made that comment about us winning the elections 8 months down the line. I think the issue is not just about giving, you know, knee-jerk reactions. You have to create an ecosystem where the farming community gets everything they need, technology, they need consolidation of land, and they need a process where, right from cold chains to the markets, to have good finances, and to for them to be able to get out of the clutches of these private money lenders. Now, what happens is, when the governments are in election year, they try and put band-aids to fix, you know, a very large open wound. That shouldn't happen. When the governments first take charge, they must have a clear roadmap, they must have targets, and they must deliver on the ground to the farming communities, because they form really the backbone of the whole agrarian economy. Congress party also gave a farm loan waiver, but that was done by the Manmohan Singh government without any prejudice about which governments in which state. We never thought BJP, Congress, Janata Dal, we gave a farm loan waiver because country could afford it. Today, state governments which are not in a position are still doing it because politically they're asked the question, if Yogi can do it, if Fadnavis can do it, why shouldn't Vasundhara do it? And I think that's the problem why she had to do this tokenism of offering this 50,000 rupee loan waiver.
Okay, tokenism from the Vasundhara Raje government. That's the view there from the Rajasthan Congress chief, Sachin Pilot. Appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV 18 to talk about the budget that was announced by the Rajasthan government today.